Hello, my name is José Marcos Ortega. I'm a professor of the Civil Engineering Department of the University of Alicante in Spain. And with this video, I will continue with the materials prepared for the online teaching of the subject, the structures 3D, of the degree in Fundamentals of Architecture here at the University of Alicante. In this tutorial, I will continue with the practical classes 8 and 9 of the subject dedicated to the design of reinforcement of beams. And we have started in the previous tutorial with this example, example designs of beams par C. In the previous video, I finished here. When the final of the video cuts my explanation, I was showing you the bending moments diagram of this beam. I told you that there are several linear parts of this bending moment diagram, and this diagram is symmetric, okay? The beam is symmetric, okay, in dimensions and also in the distribution of loads, okay? This FED is the same in both ways, then this bending moment diagram is symmetrical. Calculating the longitudinal reinforcement in this bay, in the bay AB, we have all the longitudinal reinforcement of the beam, because this bay is the distribution of the reinforcement will be symmetric than this other one, okay? But we will see that in the following steps of the exercise. First of all, as I told you, this bending moments diagram, or this beam with this particular case of concentrated loads in the midpoint of the base, is not in the our book of apuntes. Then here I will give you the bending moments equations for the part AD. AD is the this support, okay, this stream of the beam. D is the midpoint in which is applied the concentrated load, and B is the intermediate support. Then the bending moments law as a function of x. X is the coordinate from the extreme A, from the left extreme of the left extreme support of the beam. Then the bending moments equation for that part AD, is equal to 5 divided 16 multiplied by FED. FED is the combined design concentrated load multiplied by x, the distance from the extreme left support of the beam. And for the part DB, is here indicated. The bending moments equation is that one, is equal to minus 11 divided 16 multiplied again by FED, the design concentrated load, multiplied by x. X keeps the same meaning, the distance from the left extreme support of the beam, plus FED multiplied by L divided by 2, being L the length of the bay. Here is in this particular case is 5.8 meters. And the maximum positive bending moment is in the point D, in the midpoint of the bay, and the midpoint of the bay has this coordinate from the extreme A. It's 5.8 divided by 2 is 2.9 meters. Then if we take this expression and we replace the x by 2.9, which is indicated here, we put also the value of FED. FED was 114 kilonewtons. Then 5 divided 16 multiplied by 114 kilonewtons multiplied by 2.9 meters is equal to 103.3 kilonewton by meter. This is the maximum design, maximum positive design bending moment in the beam. And the maximum negative bending moment is here, is in the point B. Point B is the intermediate support of the beam. And here, which is in the part DB, we take this equation of the bending moment's law, and the point B is at a distance equal to 5.88 from the point and the extreme A. Then we replace the x by the value of 5.8 in this equation, and the value of FED by its corresponding 114 kilonewtons calculated previously, and then we replace here minus 11 divided 16 multiplied by FED, 140 kilonewtons multiplied by x for this point is 5.8 meters is here, plus FED 114 kilonewtons multiplied by L, which is 5.8 meters divided by 2, and we obtain that the bending moment, the maximum negative bending moment in this point B is equal to minus 124 kilonewton by meter. Then we have enough information to start now with the calculation of the longitudinal reinforcement of a beam. This step is a previous step, but is necessary for doing next calculations. Here in the exercise, I have included several steps in order to facilitate the understanding and comprehension of this solution. I name the main steps here as C, point, and a number, in order to make easier the explanation. The first step, I call it C1. C1 is to calculate the the reinforcement needed in the cross section with the maximum positive bending moment. We did an exercise similar to this step C1 in the session 5 of practical classes, and here we are going to do the same, but for the data of this new exercise. Remind that if we come back to the wording, the cross section has the following dimensions. Width is 30 centimeters. Okay, we design width as the letter B, and depth, we define the depth, or we design the depth with the letter H. H is equal to 40 centimeters. Then we know that. And now, remind that the maximum positive bending moment is positive, as I told you. A positive design of the bending moment gives us information about the position of the tension reinforcement and the compressed reinforcement. Here, when we have a positive bending moment, the tension is on the bottom and the compression is on the top. The cross section, on the top mid part or the bottom mid part of the cross section. Okay, here in the top mid part we have the compressions, and here, if it is necessary, we will have the compression reinforcement. As I remind you, we design the mechanical capacity of the compression reinforcement as US2. As here is indicated, these letters in Spanish means top reinforcement. And the tension reinforcement is in the bottom part of the cross section. Then here we will have the tension reinforcement, we will be the bottom reinforcement, and remind that its mechanical capacity was called US1. And here is the dimension H, the depth of the cross section, which according to the information given in the wording is 40 centimeters. For the part B, I told you, or remind you, that the part B of the exercise was proposed to you for solving by yourself at home. From this part B, we have obtained that the nominal covering is 50 centimeters, and for calculating the mechanical covering, we are going to suppose that the transverse reinforcement is arranged using bars with diameter 6 millimeters. Here is in the wording the possible diameters. And for the longitudinal reinforcements, we can choose between 16 and 20 millimeters. Here we have taken 16 millimeters as the diameter of longitudinal reinforcement to estimate the mechanical covering. And if we calculate with this data, if we calculate the mechanical covering that we obtain is 64 millimeters. And then the effective depth, D, is equal to the depth H minus the mechanical covering. Then it is equal to 400 millimeter minus 64 millimeters calculated here, and we obtain that the effective depth of this beam is of the cross section of this beam is 336 millimeters. Then we can continue with the calculation. I remind you that in the unit calculation of section subject to normal stresses, we gave you this document called unit OTEMA 225, checking and design of rectangular section subject to bending. And here we have different formulas. We have formulas for checking cross sections, and we have for the design or two dimensioning cross section. As I explained you that we have two criterions to calculate the reinforcement of a cross section subject to pure bending. One criterion is based on the limit moment, okay, the limit moment which produces the deformed cross section in the limit between the domains 3 and 4. And this limit moment was equal to 0.375 multiplied by U0 multiplied by D. This is one of the criterion. And there is another criterion in which instead of using this moment limit is used this M frontera, moment frontera, moment border, we can see, or we can tell in English, instead of the limit moment. The only thing that changes is this number. For the limit moment is 0.375, and for the moment frontera or limit moment frontera or border is 0.290. Okay, and this number also changes here when we are in case 2, and this number also changes. Here is 0.36 and here is 0.5. In the majority of exercises we have used until now this criterion. We told you that you can use in the criterion that you prefer in exams, practical exercises, etc. Okay, both are valid for us when correcting these practical exercises or exams. And now in this exercise we will use this criterion, okay, in order that you have an example of solving an exercise with this one criterion of the moment frontera or moment border. Okay, and then now we come back to the exercise solution, which is here. The first parameter that we calculate is the U0. Do you remind that U0 is equal to FCD multiplied by B multiplied by D? FCD is the design compressive strength of concrete, which is equal to FCK, which is the characteristic strength of concrete, divided by the partial safety factor of concrete. Okay, is here we use a HA35 concrete, therefore they are characteristic strength. FCK will be equal to 35 newton square millimeters or 35,000 kilonewton square meter, depending on the units that you want to express it. The partial safety factor of concrete was 1.5, and we have also B. B is 0.3. here according to the data given in the wording, and this the effective depth which have calculated here is 0.336 meters. And finally we obtain that U0 is equal to 2,352 kilonewtons. Then we can calculate now the moment frontera or border called to the MF, which is equal to 0.295 U0D, as I explained you in this summary. Okay, this is taking from here, and it's only replacing the numbers. Okay, U0 we have calculated it now, and D we know 0.33C, and then this MF is equal to 233.9 kilonewton by meter. And here is explained more or less the thing that I told you in the document 225. Here is explained this. In this case, for the design of the reinforcement, it has been chosen the criterion that MD lower or equal than M frontera or M border, or MD higher than M frontera or M border.